What's up, everybody? It's video time. I just wanted to do a quick video, very quick, because I just want to make sure that I sum everything together that I've talked about in the past, how I've talked about the crack-up boom, the Great Depression, the Greatest Depression, the hyperinflationary depression. Excuse me. And I just wanted to say we're at that point that I've been talking about all these years and all these videos and everything. We've seen the quick crash in cryptocurrencies that I said would happen. Everybody was like, cryptocurrencies are going to go, you know, Bitcoin will be like $1 million in about 2 months. Well, that may be coming down the road. But as for right now, like I said, when there's a liquidity crisis and interest rates are rising and everybody's a risk to be lending to, liquidity freezes up. Nobody wants to give up that money to anybody else because they don't want to lose it. And now you got the Fed cutting interest rates and you've got President Trump screaming for more rate cuts. So what I've done now is I've rolled my oil money into high-yielding bonds and munis. Municipal bonds. You're going to be probably confused because I said the bonds are going to collapse. Yeah, I think that will happen eventually. But initially, what's happening right now with the interest rates going down is you're allowing governments to borrow at cheaper rates so they can refinance. And you're allowing corporations to do the same. So they're just going to kick that can down the road as much as possible. Now, we don't have as much road given that the Fed has not been able to raise interest rates all the way back up to pre-2008 levels. So they don't have much room to cut. And I'm quite interested in a philosophy that I've been tossing around in my head. What would happen if the Fed just cuts straight to zero from where we are right now? I think it would cause a real surge in activity because you'd have massive refinancing of all the debt. And but there's always a downside to that because there are two sides to each coin. There's the borrower and there's the lender. And when one is benefiting, the other one is hurting. And so you're probably going to have a lot of write-downs in debt. But at the same time, you'll have a lot more productivity and business activity, provided that corporations don't do what they've been doing the past few years with their debt, which is buying back their own shares to prop up their share price in the stock market, which doesn't really equate to productivity. It equates to a higher price, but really all it is asset inflation. So it's possible if the Fed cut to zero, all we would see is just the crack up boom even worse. And I think that's coming. Because we're in a depression, you're seeing it everywhere. Everything is slowing down. Especially the European Union is hurting, and China. Initially, it's China because of the tariffs and the trade wars. Trump wanted to shake China off our back and force them to do legitimate business like we do in order to compete. And it's working because China doesn't know how to do legitimate business. They're a communist nation. Communists only know how to take from other people's productivity. So if you shake them off of you, the parasite can no longer feed off of you. And if it doesn't know how to take care of itself, it dies. So China is having major problems. And since China has been the global financier of the world off of the back of America, since it's been able to manipulate its prices and its industries as a communist nation, it doesn't have to vote for anything. The communist regime just decides we're going to do something and they do it right away. They don't have to answer to the people. They only answer to themselves. So right now we're seeing the global slowdown as a result of that because now they have to answer to the U.S. The U.S. has been setting demands and they don't want to play. They're hoping that Donald Trump will be out of office and they'll be able to hold out for the next couple years. But I doubt that that's going to happen. I think that they're going to end up crashing their economy and their stubbornness and their wanting to be such control freaks. Communism and fascism are the same bird. You know, two wings of the same bird. They're both socialism, and they both seek control, and they both seek to shirk responsibility for one's actions. They'd rather socialize it, hence the word socialism. The responsibility is the burden, the blame is spread amongst all the innocents, all the people who are not involved with that bad decision, and that's how they're able to get away with things. Because it's too much of a burden to bear it on your own. You know, rather than you go bankrupt, let's just spread the bankruptcy across 20,000 people and it'll be easier to bear, right? Rather than one person bear it. That's the philosophy of socialism, which is really retarded. Instead of production, they're destruction. So anyway, you're seeing the rest of the world slow down as a result, because China was pretty much driving everything. The U.S. was buying everything from China, and then China was using the profits to buy everything from the rest of the world. So now if the U.S. stops buying things from China because of the tariffs, because the stuff is too expensive, and we start doing business with smaller Southeast Asian entities that can produce the same thing but cheaper and in a legitimate fashion, you know, China's going to dry up. All that investment around the globe is going to dry up. We're in a global depression. And so you're going to see a lot more central banks going to have to cut rates in order to stimulate, well, supposedly stimulate production, but we're in a depression. Nobody's going to want stuff. So the reality of it is all it's going to result in is asset inflation. So this is why, going back to my bond issues, I went into munis and I went into high yield bonds, because guess what, they're high yield, and as they're cutting rates, I currently hold the rate that it's at, then they cut rates, that makes my rate more, as an income producer, more valuable. And so I see myself with some more asset appreciation in value and income. So this is my strategy. And I think down the road, oil is going to go up again. But right now, the demand for it is down. And you're going to see a lot, because the price is going down, you're seeing a lot of oil refiners and exploration companies going bankrupt. So they're seeing their money dry up because the price of their good is plummeting. So the cost hasn't gone down, but the amount of money that they can make has gone down. And so they cannot continue to finance stuff. So it's going to be very interesting to see the future. The future is going to be very dangerous. And I think if you haven't prepared, I don't know that you'll be able to prepare. I'm going to open the door here just because I like the air to come into the car, and I don't have to open the window. It comes in a lot better with the door open. Plus it makes my light come on and I can do the video better. But I'm almost at 10 minutes, so I want to cut it there. I am, as Bitcoin and Litecoin are going down, I'm buying more. And anyway, like I said, I'm in the bonds right now, and I'm having that income come back in and repurchase the oil as it drops. So that's my strategy for right now. This is not financial advice. I'm just telling you what I'm doing. If you want to do it, I'm not responsible for any losses or gains you might make or acquire or realize as a result of following my strategy. That's entirely up to you. But I do recommend that you prepare in some way. Have some food, water for at least 6 months, because you don't know what's going to happen in a depression. I mean, you may see store shelves just dry up and there may be no food and no water for your family. And good luck growing food at that point when you really need it, and especially if you don't have any water. Now, if you're in the Midwest, you got floods there, so all you have to do is pretty much desalinate or filter the water, and you've got some potable water, but you need electricity for that. Your electric bills may go up. You may not have any cash to pay your electric bills. Who knows? Maybe you need to get a solar rig together. Who knows what you need to do? But you need to decide what you need to do to prepare. And I'm just setting you up for that, to warn you that it's time to do it. All right, with that, I love you guys. If you're the first time viewer, please hit that like button and subscribe. Hit the bell notification so you know the next time that I release another video. And most importantly, share it with those you think can benefit from this information. And go back into my archives, listen to the other videos. to be sure that I'm telling you the truth, that I've always been saying this, and you know, and it's coming to the point where it's all coming to fruition. We're at an end game, just like I was talking about with the Avengers movie coming out. All these things are end game, like Walking Dead. Everything was prepping us for this time. All these movies and everything, they're telling us they're going to end it all for us. So we just need to be ready for it. All right, anyway, and also please follow my affiliate links. You know, purchase something from down there. If you like, I'm not telling you what to do, but I'm just saying your support is greatly appreciated since I am not monetized on YouTube. I'm trying to find a way to monetize YouTube at least, so I'm compensated for the time it takes for me to share the information and my knowledge and my experience with you guys, and the motivation for you to educate yourself as well. I also have donation links below for my cryptocurrencies, so if you want to donate Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dash, anything, take your pick, and it's much appreciated. Thank you to those who have already donated, and thank you to those who will donate in the future. And God bless you, watch over you, be prepared. Take care.